Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in a Cube. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how a conditional drill and a paginated report helped me solve a really specific problem. Stay tuned. If you're finding this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and myself. All right. Conditional drill and a paginated report. What problem did they help you solve, Patrick? Well, I was working with the customer and they had kind of like this summary detail report that they were trying to create in Power BI. And I was like, use paginated report. And they were like, no, Patrick, we want to stay in Power BI as much as we possibly can. In fact, when I first introduced Power BI reports, they were like, no way, no way, no way, no way. And I convinced them to use it as a complement to the Power BI report. So here's a scenario. They have a list of items, like a summary of all the invoices, all the products in one table. And then below, they want to see all the details about it. The challenge was that bottom table was in direct query, and sometimes there were two rows and sometimes there were 10, 20 million rows below in that bottom table. And there's some limitations on export and how much data can be visualized in a direct query table in Power BI. So we had to come up with a workaround. And you guys are like, stop talking, Patrick, show us how to do it. Instead of all this talking, you guys know what I like to do? Let me show you, let's head over to my laptop. So this is where we started. The first thing I did was I created a table, a distinct table of all the products. In my case, in your case, it could be invoices or sales orders or whatever it is you're trying to create. And you can see I have a distinct list of products and I included the total number of invoices associated with each product. You may be like, why? And I'm like, hang on. I'm gonna show you why I included that. So after we created the table, we created a few measures. So let me show you. So the first measure we created was this threshold. And you may be thinking, that's simple. Well, I put it there because I'm using this threshold in multiple measures. So I don't wanna go across all those measures to change it. So I put it there, I can change it in one place, then all my measures will pick it up. But the purpose of this was there was a negotiation between us and the report consumers. And I said, hey, if you're in Power BI, what's the smallest amount of details that are okay, right? That's acceptable for you to view. And they were like, 100,000. I was like, are you really gonna scroll through 100,000? They were like, 50,000. I was like, are you really gonna, you know? And we finally came up to 1,000. They were like, all right, if we see 1,000, we can scroll through that and kind of eyeball it, and we really don't need to export it. Anything greater than that, I need the ability to view them all and export them all. I was like, okay, so we'll set the threshold at 1,000. The next thing we did was we created this disabled message, and I'll show you how we use this disabled message when we set everything up. And so you can see I'm using the threshold here. So I'm kind of just telling them using that threshold in a message that I'm going to use later in my report. And then I created the detail navigation check. Again, I'm using the thresholds. You can see why I created that measure. If I change it in one place, right? If they decide, hey, it's 500 or 10,000, we can easily go change it. So that's the first thing that I pulled into this measure. The next thing is I've checked to make sure that this table is filtered. I need to make sure this is filtered. Then I grabbed the invoices and then I did a check on the threshold. I said, if the product invoices is less than or equal to that threshold, true. And then I wrapped it all up in an if, and I said, if both of these conditions are met, if that table is filtered and you're less than a threshold, allow you to go to the product invoice details. Otherwise, don't do anything. After I got those measures set up, then it was time for me to configure the conditional drill so that if they select something that was greater than my threshold, it wouldn't allow them to drill. If they select something that was less than my threshold, it allowed them to drill. Once I added the button to the page, I started doing some configuration. So by default, the button text, I just said, you know, see product invoice details. That's the default state. For my disabled state, I did some conditional stuff. So you can see there's no text here. Clicked on the function button. You'll see the field value is selected. And then I found that disabled message measure. Say that 10 times. All right. Now you can see it's showing, hey, it's disabled because I have more than 1,000 product invoices. The next thing I did was I configured the action. So I turned on the action, I set the type to drill through, and then I did a little conditional destination. Make sure field value, that's only value, right? And then find my measure, the detail navigation check. So now with all that configured, if I choose something that's less than 1,000, let's see what happens, right? Ah, now I can drill to my product details. If I choose something that's greater than 1,000, it says, hey, you need to go generate a paginated report. Once I did that, then I published the report out to Power BI. We created a separate data model and we published the data model out, and then we connected Power BI to it and we built our report. For the sake of brevity, I'm just using, you know, a consolidated report in a data model. But be sure, if you can, separate your data model and your data set, okay? So we got it published out. The reason I published it out at this point is because I wanted to use this data set to do what? Create my paginated report. When I have that one central data set or data model, you know, across both Power BI and paginated reports. So we downloaded the latest report builder. The next thing we did was created that paginated report. I downloaded the latest Power BI report builder. And I created a blank report, right click on data sources, and you can see there's an option for a Power BI dataset connection. So then I go to the workspace and I choose my dataset. Once the data source is there, then I start creating some data sets. So you right click here, you choose add data set, and you can see I created one here, wrote a little DAX, didn't use the query builder, I wrote the DAX myself, and then I created another data set for my parameter. You need to hang on to the name of this parameter because we'll use it later when we start configuring the button that's actually gonna take us to this paginated report. After we created this paginated report, we saved it up to Power BI, and then we headed over to Power BI and we did a test because we wanted to make sure this report ran. So go ahead and click it. Just give it a few seconds to run. It's connecting to my data set. Actually hadn't connected to the data set because it said, hey, you need to provide a parameter. Now I can click this and scroll through a long list of items, or I can just start typing. There's a little free text box that kind of does a wildcard search for me. So if I type 480, it's going to filter it down to all the product keys that start with 48 or include 48. And I click it and now it's going to render my report and it's going to filter my report for just the product key 487. So everything is working. This is great. Once we verified that it works, we went into the URL and copied everything up until this question mark. We don't need anything after the question mark. Get that on your clipboard. After we got that on our clipboard, we went back to our Power BI data model and we added an additional measure. So let me show you this measure. So the first thing we did was I created a variable and I dropped in that base URL. Maybe you have a different report or you want to use it somewhere else. And so I dropped it right there. And then what I did was I created another variable that grabbed the selected product key. So whichever item I have selected here, it's going to tuck that in a variable for me. Then I start building out my URL parameters. The very first one is setting the product key. Remember I said you needed to hold on to the name of that parameter from the paginated report? Well, this is why. And so I said product key equals to my selected product. And then I added three additional ones. And so then I added my export format because one of the requirements they came back to say that with one of the report consumers said, hey, when you click this button, when we go over to this report, we want it to automatically download the CSV because we need to do our own work. And so that's what this parameter is. It's an RDL format CSV. You can make PDF, you can do lots of other things. And then they also wanted a page view. And I'll show you the difference between a default view and a page view once we render the report. And also they wanted to be Chromeless. Let's remove all the noise in the browser. So then I just kind of concatenated everything up and built that string. And then finally, you can see the second button that I added on the page. All I did was I configured it to go to a web URL. So I enabled the action, chose web URL type, clicked on the function, and then I found the paginated report URL. Click OK. Once I was done, we published the report out to Power BI, and I was so excited. I was like, oh, I can't wait to show this to everyone that's going to consume it, because now we have this kind of summary, conditional, paginated report, details drill that's going to do it based on how many items that's associated with the given product or invoice. I was really excited about this. So head back over to Power BI, and then we're going to go to that Power BI report. So here's my Power BI report. Check this out. So if I choose an item that's less than 1,000, boom, go see your product invoice details. If I choose something that's greater than 1,000, you got to generate a paginated report. Now they could generate a paginated report either way. Doesn't matter. Okay. So we'll click here. Let's see what this invoice details looks like. All right. There's all my invoice details. So fast, just works all for my product stand. Now, what about if I choose something, let's say I choose this one, right? Finger gloves, large half finger gloves. I can't go to my details report because I have more than 1,000 invoices, but hey, let's generate a paginated report. We click here, give it just a few seconds. It's gonna connect to my data set. You can see it set that parameter for it. It's gonna render my report. It's gonna be Chromeless and it's gonna be in the page view. So you can see all the Power BI stuff is kind of collapsed for me. I'm in this nice page view. It actually downloads the CSV file. You can see I've done this a couple of times. Let's go ahead and open this in the background so you can see what this looks like. While it's opening, if I switch, you can see in my view, I'm set to page view right now. That's because of that URL parameter that I set. Report view equals page view. I can go back to the default view. When I showed them this, they were like, this is nice, but I prefer the other view. So I defaulted it to page view. And also we kind of got rid of the Chrome around it. If I click this, you can see it brings everything back. All right, what is the export looks like? Is that what you're asking me? Take this out. All right, and here's the export of all the data I got. All the data that I need. What do you guys think? It's pretty nice, pretty cool solution. Helped me solve a problem by using different features in Power BI. I was able to satisfy my report consumers. This is great. Have you ran into anything like this? Do you have any challenges like this that you think you can melch something together like I'm using in with the conditional drill in Power BI? I'd love to know. Questions, comments? Let's continue the conversation. Where? In the comments below. Your first time visiting? Ow, ow, ow. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button, like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.